There truly was a crisis event the other day. Welcome to Monday Night CAW. So much has happened. So many changes are upon us. Joined by Mr. John Von Hollywood, of course.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to our post-crisis event, our most recent pay-per-view. It was great. We had some great matches. Please check it out if you have it. And we've got more to come throughout the end of this year and into next year. But first, Ace has something to say.
Even though it is not 2024 yet, I am very proud to announce that I will be the acting general manager of CAW starting on January 1st. Big changes are upon us here at Shock Wrestling, and I am looking for the very best, because not all of you are keeping your jobs here on CAW.
Oh, that's going to cause some rambunctiousness in the locker room, folks. You heard it here first. Ace is going to be causing chaos.
And here,
we have Paz versus Hieu.
Here's Paz versus a guy that maybe will have a job at the end of the year, Hieu.
Maybe. Paz might have a job at the end of the year as well, since he will not let go of the So Far So Good title.
He has been defending it every week, and any challenger could accept. This could be a big moment for Hieu. I mean, a lot of people backstage see a lot of potential in Hieu, including Rob. Rob's been helping out Hieu, giving him advice.
As he has been creeping out some of the Bloodline members, mostly the Hammer Bros, I believe, with Luke and Hieu, as they just recently have started tag teaming again.
Yeah, had a little reunion.
The British are after Hieu for some reason, so I'd be careful if I were Hieu. Funny joke. I apologize, folks. We're kicking off after crisis strong. Paz, though, defended the title multiple times throughout the past few months. And still continues to defend it till the end of the year.
He's taken on the likes of Devil Han, Frogman, the Raven, like so many different kinds of competitors, and he's only got a couple of short weeks left until, dare I say, could he be just as crowd-pleasing as the former champion?
Oh, yes, and Paz is here. Now, listen, folks. So Far So Good television champion's one thing, but we also have the M2J2 championship that is controlled by Robert.
Yeah. Rob, I believe, will be in action later tonight trying to avenge his triple threat loss at Crisis against the Raven and Perkin. Do you think him and Perkin are getting along?
Him and Perkin?
Yeah, you think they're getting along after their little miscommunication, I'll say?
You'll say miscommunication. I have no trust for anything the British Invasion does. I do believe that it was all planned and there were shenanigans being thrown around at Crisis. I think it was all part of the plan. Until, you know, they didn't win.
There he is. Paz is here. TV title on the line. Do you think anyone's getting bored of Paz, or is it exciting every week?
Well, let me tell you, Ace, I'm not bored of Paz. So I don't care what anybody else thinks. Paz can stay here and stay champion forever if he wanted to. See, Paz is like my Gunther, right?
Oh.
Hold that Intercontinental title, break the record, and be cool. Yeah, that's all I got for Paz.
I think Paz is now the longest reigning TV champion.
Possibly. So Far So Good hasn't been around as long as the M2J2 title, technically, right?
Right.
It went, yeah. And I don't think the M2J2 championship has... Any N2J2 champion has held the belt as long as the So Far So Good belt now.
Yeah, we had the summer.
He's had
Mooch.
It for a while. Mooch!
And Paz won the title back at Tidal Wave, which was in August. Yeah, we're now 4 months into this reign.
This is insane, folks. Will Hieu be able to stop it here tonight on this Monday Night Call after the crisis?
I don't know about this era of Ka per se, but let's just say Ace's Monday Night Ka is going to be the land of opportunity. I think we're going to see matches like this where we see up-and-coming stars getting Ace's big opportunity. Era. Yeah, but Ace's Monday Night Ka coming soon.
Don't know about this era? Dude, if we didn't have this era, there wouldn't be an Ace's Monday Night Ka.
Okay.
There'd be a No Day Night Ka.
That's like saying without Hulk Hogan, you don't get Will Ospreay, but Will
Ospreay. Why are we talking about wrestling? That's like saying without the first Iron Man movie, we wouldn't have any of the MCU. I get it sucks now, Ace, but that's not my fault. I created Iron Man.
The clothesline there from Paz kicking things off, but oh, look at this from Hieu. Taking control.
Into a submission. Oh, trying to break his neck. Now, Paz is a big guy. He's able to throw Hieu off of him.
And some hits here.
We got two different weight classes pretty much going on here.
Yeah.
Hugh's much lighter, but he's able to challenge the big guy of Paz. Let's see what he's got here. Big hit to the face of Paz.
And some more hits to the back. Very aggressive start here from Hieu. Oh!
Now, I'd be a little embarrassed if Paz is taken out by Hieu!
Flying like a dragon. There goes Hieu.
Nice. Hugh's rubbing the fingers together like Matthew McConaughey. I feel like it was a sign.
We've had many dragons in wrestling. The American Dragon, Bryan Danielson, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, the Ultimate Dragon. Hieu is trying to take on that nickname, the Dragon, which that's a big thing to put on you. That's a big legacy.
Or he'll just be like Dragon Lee and be okay.
That's
I'm
true.
I'm sorry. I had to bully one of the dragons, and that was the only one I could think of bullying. I like you, Dragon Lee. You're pretty cool.
It wasn't your fault.
It wasn't your fault, you know. It's Hieu and Paz. Oh, there we go. Paz knows what John Von Hollywood wants. Throw them back into the ring. End the match. Come on, Paz. Oh, big fist to the face of Hieu there.
He's
had a wild year here at Shock Wrestling. Bloodline falling apart, coming together, Hammer being a bully. I think it's time he has earned the right to take down Paz. Can he do it? Oh,
hits
the arm.
A former tag team champion, but has not won a singles title yet here at Shock Wrestling.
Ooh. Him and Javon had quite the arc during Triple F a few months ago. Both of them, I've always wanted to go after the Triple F belt, but that's okay, because the belt's in good hands.
It is, with Nova, who the Super Goats will be in action tonight against Adam and a mystery tag partner.
So I've heard, Ace.
Yeah. Look at this. He missed.
Off of the second rope. Oh. It's Paz's turn. Is he going to do a big rope move here?
Oh, the boomerang.
The boomerang. Boing.
Good day.
One, two, kick out.
Wow.
Hieu is able to kick out of the boomerang by the Aussie Assassin. Oh. I can't believe it.
Look at this. Down under.
Hieu is lying in state. Oh, there you go. Sweep of the legs there. Hieu was able to recover very quickly against Paz here. The so far so good championship on the line.
Hieu could get it here. This is an opportunity.
Yes, as Hieu throws Paz against the ropes.
Oh! The strength. This is a very...
Two.
Cover and a kick out. I was going to mention Hieu has a very mixed martial arts background. He knows how to hurt his opponent.
And Paz, that kick out there, he had to worm out of that one.
Yeah. Oh!
Off the edge of the ring.
What a way to kick off Ka.
Fell down under.
Throwing him back in. Do you think he's showing he's showing the legends, legends could be very impressed? Oh, because the legends did lose against the originals.
which I was shocked by, if I'm going to be completely honest, Ace. It was a wild event at Crisis. Oh, big kick there by Hieu. Uh-oh.
Oh, man.
I don't think the Legends respect Paz enough, though.
Whoa! Oh, what an elbow.
He flew across the wall!
This is insane.
Look at this.
To crown a new champion.
Two!
No!
A kick out by Paz, though, at the last second. Hieu can't believe it.
Oh!
Hieu gets another move in on him there. All right.
Yeah, this is a beatdown. Fight forever chance.
Nice. Just started, folks. Come on.
And now Paz. Oh! Right hands.
There you go.
That's the Aussie aggression from the Aussie assassin.
Into a pin on Hubie Doobie Doo. One. Oh! Kick out immediately.
Hieu is not going down without a fight. Oh.
Ooh.
Oh. That's the thing.
Just keep trying to keep him down, because if Hieu is up, he is able to recover.
What's he thinking here? DDT, and Hieu's bleeding.
He did a full flip on that one.
And what's Paz thinking? Oh, he was thinking about the boomerang, but I think Hieu was a little too far. Oh!
Rolling him back over.
Once again, that can't
adjust for the boomerang shot. You gotta throw it a certain way so it comes back to you.
Oh.
Allows Hieu to be able to recover against Paz here. Hits to the back of the giant. Oh, no.
This could be the opportunity Hieu needed.
Ooh. Hieu looks like he's trying to set up for a suplex, but Paz is not allowing it.
Yeah, let's see what he's thinking here. Oh, gearing up for something. There it is.
Stomping on Paz's shoulder. Will Hieu be able to end it here?
Ooh.
He wants the shoulder to stay down. Ace, you know.
This could be it right here. Another elbow.
Oh,
and now just...
Ref got in the way.
Now, oh, there it is.
Oh! All right, Hieu, pin him.
TV champ?
So far, so good champ.
No.
God damn it.
Still a kick out.
Paz rolls away. He needs some time to recover, but Hieu is not allowing it. He wants this championship from the top rope.
Oh!
Elbow to the back of Paz's neck.
This might be
brutalization by Hieu here.
This might be Paz's biggest challenge yet. Oh.
What is Hieu doing? He accidentally looked under the ring.
Was that the Rob in his head, maybe?
Oh god. We all have a little bit of Rob in our head. Hieu from the top once again.
What are we gonna see? No! Paz isn't letting it happen.
And Paz throws him down. Oh, Paz setting up here.
He got a little cocky there, I think. Drop kick. Oh, gearing up. This is what the Aussie assassin does. Oh!
Paz knocks down Hieu.
Oh, once again, was trying to set up for that boomerang.
You know, once he messed it up once earlier, Hieu was able to kick out of it. It must have thrown Paz off of his game here, but look at this.
Oh, man.
Look at this!
Oh, man. Off the rope! That's gotta be it.
One, two, three.
Got it. What a match.
I believe the Hammer Bros themselves have won matches with that move.
It might be possible, yeah. You gotta give it to Hieu. There were some moves we've never seen from him.
Yes. Good job, Hieu. Good loss, Hieu. good job, Paz.
Yeah, another retain.
So, Ace, we only have a few more weeks left in the year. Actually, one, two, three more episodes of CAW left this year, Ace.
Huge.
Will Paz continue defending his title for every episode and retain it throughout the end of this year on Monday Night CAW?
I mean, so far, so good. No pun intended.
Nice. I like it.
But big congrats to Paz. What a first match here on CAW.
Now, what do we have next, folks? Jaiden and Warp versus Animus and Andre.
Oh, jeez.
So Animus is still what do we call him? Their leader of the job squad? The man in black? The man behind the curtain?
Yeah.
What was he? The higher power! That's what he was called.
Yes. The higher power. Of the BWI. Or not the BWI, the Jobbers Union. Oh, God.
Bro, if the Jobbers Union and the BWI were a money laundering scheme, I wouldn't be surprised.
Just a triangle scheme. Pyramid scheme.
So, listen to all these boos for Animus, though. I do have to say, I enjoyed that a lot, Ace, because Animus was on the greatest tag team at Shock Wrestling, the Wings of Destruction, until he betrayed the Raven. And, Ace, nothing's been the same since.
Well, here comes the guy you've beaten. Did you give him back the cardboard title?
Well, I can tell you I didn't give it to him.
Oh.
So if he has it, so it's not stolen. I have it locked away. Speaking of titles, Ace, Comic Book Wrestling ended and caused some chaos. Some things are just missing here from Shock Wrestling, locked away in a little tiny vault that I have no access to. So yeah, I guess you guys will have to stay tuned until next year to see what happens with some of those titles. You know, if you want them back, comment. If you like our show, subscribe. This is my plug, please. This is Andre walking out, and we gotta make sure people are tuning in. We got a lot of subscribers throughout this year. I'm proud of us.
Yeah.
And everybody who watches, I hope you enjoy it.
When we, wait, Andre's about to hit more pyro.
Bro, what? I didn't give him that!
Wow. It is Monday Night Roberts right now here at
Ace
the show.
Ace being sus over here, knowing extra pyro was set up for Andre. Is there more? Oh, thank God.
Well, I'm going to be in charge in a couple weeks. I read the show notes. I'm getting to learn my roster.
Where in the hell did the notes look? They were written by Andre for his entrance.
Yeah, it was in his handwriting.
It was very clearly Andre's handwriting.
But Warp and Jaiden, okay. So
I'm going to say it.
Yeah.
It's my favorite tag team now since Wings of Destruction are broken.
They had a complicated crisis, but they got through it.
They did get through it. And by the way, the week before Crisis was the Jaiden and Warp show. It was like 90s Raw. They appeared like five times in the episode. I must have heard my goddamn theme that, if you don't remember, folks, they stole from me. They're here a lot, but I like them. I hope they destroy whatever the hell Animus and Andre are calling themselves these days. Monday Night Roberts gear. You think he's happy for you, Ace?
Probably not, because he's definitely, I'm not saying he's on the chopping block, but he's not a first priority of this new regime, if you know what I mean.
Ooh. I see. As Jaiden going after Andre, former world champion Jaiden here at Shock Wrestling, is he going to be able to clear house tonight in this tornado tag matchup?
A lot of tag teams put on notice after we crowned new tag team champions last night with Nye and Slime Theory.
Hold on. See, I haven't been paying attention to the dirt sheets or anything.
So
I don't know what chaos you may be causing.
Well, the new clique now control the tag division. It's a little chaotic. As Jaiden breaks it up in this tornado tag match. But, yeah.
Oh, you meant put on notice for that. I thought you sent out an email.
No.
I didn't realize everybody realized we got these new tag champs. I see what you're saying. Yes.
And I think, I think people are trying to see, trying to figure out who the next challenger is, I believe.
Oh, okay. I was going to say Jaden's going to win, but he was thrown out of the ring by Animus.
Now, Warp and Jaiden famously have never won the tag titles, but they've had many opportunities. Do you think that they're just not champion material?
No, Ace, I think their time is coming. I think that they will be able to accomplish the tag team champions here at Shock Wrestling sooner rather than later. Could it be before the end of this year? I don't know. But hopefully, that'd be cool, because I don't want the Click to have the belts.
Yeah. McHale's been talking up a storm about it. Even though he lost...
Sorry, who?
Yeah, let me repeat myself. He lost his match against me last night in a ladder match. And we'll talk more about that later, because we'll have an interesting matchup soon. Good work, though. Beating on Andre on the outside.
Let's see. Put down Animus.
Oh, camel clutch.
Going through something. There we go. Will he tap?
Right.
I always want to start counting, but that's not the way this works.
Right on his parts of the face that's been burnt.
Did you hear Andre get smacked outside of the ring there by Warp? Andre getting beat up in front of our announcer that we never use and our bell ring guy.
Andre's had a rough couple weeks. He lost against you in his own rules match.
That happens. Sometimes you need to suffer.
You destroyed an entire ring.
I did. It was an accident. My anger.
You knocked him out.
I did. I didn't even pay attention to that part. I was more annoyed that we had to wait a few minutes to reset the weight.
Oh, ow! Pop a power bomb. Super kick.
Oh!
Look at this.
Both teams going back and forth.
Into a pin.
Two.
Oh! And a kick out from Jaiden.
Jaiden was able to stop it as Warp came flying in like the Enterprise.
Oh, it is all Warp right now.
I was going to say, I've been rooting on Jaiden this whole matchup, but Warp has been able to handle his own as the sleeper is put on. Jaiden just punched Warp in the stomach to get him out of that. I don't know how useful that may have been.
Oh,
Jaiden gets hit from behind by Animus. Oh, Warp bleeding.
This is insane. What a
complete
match.
Complete chaos here the night after Crisis.
Oh, Swanton. Into a
Animus
pin.
With a pin. Two.
Got it.
Wow. That was an amazing matchup, folks. I can't believe it. That was...
So
that was intense.
Even though Animus got the pin, Andre getting his mojo back?
Was that a question?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. No? So what? What do we have to do? Do these two have to be put in a special match now? What do I have to do with these losers? I dislike this team.
Yeah, the Jobbers Union, not really anybody's favorite.
I only got 3 more weeks left of this. I don't know what I'm supposed to book these guys for.
Yeah.
Nothing. How about you fire both of them? Here, Ace. Forgot. You're in charge after this. Fire both of these guys.
I mean, I might.
Now it's time for the Raven to come out and play.
Yeah, so this is an interesting match. The winner of this match will face Nova for the Triple F title next week.
Raven.
So, you wouldn't mind the Raven becoming Triple F champion?
No, but I like Nova as Triple F champion. So,
So it's a win-win for you.
I mean, I guess. I feel like... our Gingerweight champion needs to focus on retaining that title.
He did. He did against Perkin and Rob.
I get that, but go after Robert. Get that M2J2 title.
Good idea.
That, to me, should be the priority for the Raven, as the Raven is like the... You know the snail? The snail theory that you'd get like $1 billion, but there's the slowest snail ever. If he touches you, you die, but it follows you. It's Sulley! Raven's like that. He's always just following Rob, you know, and I feel like he needs to get him, you know, get the belt from him. Put him in his place. We don't need Rob. We got Sulley.
Do you think Sulley be a good Triple F champion?
No. Sulley has won, I believe, two matches from me watching him this year. I fired him from booking with me after our, by the way, our greatest show, B-show this year, PWF. It went so well, I said, Sulley, you're not allowed to be a part of it. He had a great matchup also, like, last week.
Yeah.
Sulley versus Big H. That was pretty fun.
Yeah, we had Sulley versus Big H in a very fun match. He picked up a victory, and that's led him into this match, I think.
Well, you know.
Lost against Jab, though, at Crisis. There
yeah.
he is.
For the PWF. Mooch!
Now.
That's why I had to start with the weird, the Raven thing, because, you know, each of these guys have one.
I know you would love a Mooch Triple F title reign. He says, though, this is not going to distract him from getting that M2J2 championship back. He will come back for Rob, he says.
Yes, I love that it's no longer the Mooch championship, but everybody's respectfully recalled it the M2J2 championship since Rob has required it. acquired it, I mean... But, yes, Mooch, he deserves all the belts.
Oh.
Yeah.
You're a big
fan.
Good
for him. I'm big fan. Big Mooch guy.
But
Raven wearing some classic outfit going on here.
Yeah, here we go. Triple threat action. I think this is interesting because you have two guys, Mooch and the Raven, probably two future world champions, in my opinion. And then you have Sulley, who's a legend, former world champion, but trying to bounce back after a rough year.
Oh. Yes, I was a big fan of Sulley, but, you know, you start off by losing to You Shall Not Be Named, it's really hard.
Mooch already
Look at
getting
Mooch
the steps.
With the steps. Just taking a walk around the ring.
It is no disqualification.
Raven beating up Sulley. This might be unfair because Raven's way too talented for Sulley throughout this whole last year.
Wow.
Oh, Raven, never mind. Into the stairs.
Oh, my God.
What the pin?
This might be it.
Two.
Oh.
Raven whacking his head and his shoulder off the side of those stairs I thought put him out.
Whoa. Oh.
Sulley with the big boot coming in from the side. Sully's staying in this matchup. The ref tripped over the stairs.
Oh no.
Now,
Mooch. He's trying to grab that. Oh.
Quit playing around with the stairs.
Oh, God. What's Mooch thinking? Ankle lock. It's locked in.
It's all tied up here, folks, as Raven's coming in for the stoppage of play here. Everybody throwing their dirty laundry. Oh, jeez. We got a flag on the play. Oh.
Now, Mooch.
Sorry.
Off the ropes.
I forgot what it was.
Nope.
And I stood up too quickly. I fell asleep.
And Mooch. Oh!
Oh! Raven coming. He does not want Mooch to be the crowd pleaser in this matchup. Look at Raven.
Yeah.
Mooch is trying to get everybody on his side. Raven keeps stopping them in their tracks. Getting after Sulley.
Oh!
Oh! I just saw that move. So how Hieu lost against Pass. It must be an Australian thing. I guess Raven did the move.
And now the Raven getting thrown back in as well. Let's see what Sully's going to do. Oh, grabbing. Oh, double team. Okay. Oh, double DDT onto the Aussie.
So he did not need that. It's so.
Oh, look at Mooch, though. Ankle lock again.
The ref wasn't even looking.
Oh.
There we go. PWF guy. Not champ. Guy. Going after Mooch.
Oh. Oh. Speared by Mooch. Into the ground. Oh. The Raven, though. No, Mooch just throwing him off.
Are you going to do something, man?
Just really bullying Sulley.
I mean, it could have been a Raven versus Mooch match.
Wow. Oh, here it is. The Mooch combo.
Will that put Raven down into a pin? Sulley, are you coming in for the stoppage? There you go.
Breaks
Sulley, pin him. Pin him, Sulley.
Oh, staring
See,
down
now
Mooch.
Now I'm cheering for him. And look what he does.
Oh.
This is what I get. It's like me rooting for the Steelers.
Oh, man. Did they win today?
I don't know. I was just about to look it up.
Oh, super kick.
Super kick by the Raven on the Mooch. I can't believe it, Ace.
Into a
He's
pin.
He's done for. What? Wait.
Got it.
What? Raven. Well, that was... I'm the bully? I'm the one who's bullying Sulley. He was just taking a nap.
It was every man for themselves.
Whatever. I looked up Ravens versus Steelers because I was talking about the Raven, and that's not who it was.
The Raven kind of stole that victory from Mooch.
Good for him.
The Gingerweight champion might be two-belt Raven by the end of next week. I'm sure Nova was watching.
Well,
I'm excited for that match.
That's great, but I think Raven needs to get his priorities straight. That's all. Anyway, Devilhan is very angry, folks. The last month for him, you know, I don't know if you've seen it, comic book wrestling was chaos. He didn't have that good of a time. I mean, he did when he got rid of the comic book, though. But he wants to send Brett out in a match against, if I'm reading this correctly, Big H.
This isn't nice.
What's not nice? Devilhan or Big H?
Devilhan just putting Brett out there to get beat up.
Hold on. Listen, I've seen Big H recently. I'm not trying to say he's gotten slow over this year.
Oh.
But I think Brett will fare well against Big H. Now, I do agree that Devilhan putting him in there is not necessarily nice.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Like, this is... He's supposed to be like his apprentice.
Holy shit! Holy crap,
Look
folks,
at them.
We gotta stop the show! Nicholas showed up to a Monday night call? I can't believe it! Hold on, I gotta put on my headset, Do I need to shake his hand, Ace? Am I supposed to get up out of my seat because he actually showed up? Didn't defend the European title at Crisis, folks, but was there too!
The crowd-pleasing European champion has arrived. Along with the PWF champion Jab. Look at all of them. This is a great moment.
Cool.
This is a great moment. Look how great our European champion looks.
Big H just dancing in the background like, okay guys, you know it's my match.
Yep.
Let me do me.
Yeah, Big H will be in action up against Brett, but I'm glad the whole So Far So Good team is here.
So far.
Oh. But, yeah, here we go. This is going to be interesting.
Oh, that is a size difference.
Oh,
ha!
look at
that, Ace! Stomp to that chest. Oh, no.
Oh.
There we go.
Oh!
Take the big man down. That's the way you need to do it here, folks. Big fist to the face of Big H by Brett. Devilhan cheering him on outside of the ring. Now, I don't trust Devilhan, very much like the British Invasion, where he could be evil, pull some shenanigans.
It's very true. Oh, my God, look at him.
The strength of Brett.
Oh, is that
into
enough?
A pin. Two.
Oh, kick out from Big H. The shoulder was up.
Look, Ace, I told you, Brett's got this handled.
Big H has got a lot of stamina, though.
By the power of the devil.
Oh, God.
There he goes.
Oh, there we go.
He's throwing him outside of the ring. He kept him in there for a big elbow by Big H.
Yeah, Big H didn't like that.
Clothesline.
This is not looking good for Brett.
It's like watching Rey Mysterio versus anyone. Just the size difference.
Yeah, Big H, this is really not looking good.
He's a full foot taller than Brett.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Why did Devil Hun suggest this match?
I mean, Devil Hun, I haven't even seen him in a match since he lost. Loser.
He was just in that cell match. Oh, look at Brett!
Which he also lost.
Yeah. That's very true. That's very true.
Oh.
Brett, though. Oh!
There you go. Once again, you gotta keep Big H down. That's the only method of being able to beat the giant here at Shock Wrestling.
Look how good Nicholas looks there.
It's the back of his head.
He's a fashion icon. As Big H. Oh!
I can confuse him with any other 30 persons in our locker room. One! Two!
Oh!
Oh, a kick out by Brett!
Brett is trying.
Keep wanting to say Brett! The devil's bread.
And some more kicks there. Oh. Oh, God.
Uh-oh.
Oh, man. Oh!
Throwing away Brett.
This is not looking good for Brett right now.
I can't believe it. Brett was doing so well, but oh!
Oh, man.
Big hook there by Big H.
Big H wants the top rope.
Oh, this never ends well.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, my God. Oh!
Into a pin on Brett.
God. That was brutal.
Wow.
Oh, man. Poor Brett.
That was an insane matchup.
Oh,
hey,
my God.
Brett did way better than you gave him credit for, though, Ace.
He crushed him like a bug.
Squash you like a bug. Big H.
Look at
celebrating.
There
so
they
far,
are.
So good.
Woo! Now, those guys, you guys have a job. Don't you worry. Guaranteed contracts, no problem.
It's time for that Robert match that we wanted.
Oh, good. I wonder who he's facing.
I wonder as well. I'll probably just put it in the match card anyway. The man who is suing Paz. What's this for, Ace? I thought this was your guy.
Yeah, I just...
Oh, now you're sick of him?
He's got to go against me. He deserves better.
But
yeah, you heard me.
What do you think is the point of this match? Is Ozzy going after the M2J2 belt?
I think Rob's just bullying.
Oh.
I think Rob's mad he lost, and now he's trying to pick on some of the younger guys in the locker room.
I don't know, man. I think the Aussie Avatar deserves the. Whatever.
Hey,
teammates.
Avatar's got to win over the guard. We can't forget that.
Yeah, for some reason. It's not my fault the guard sucks now.
Here they come. Rob, Perkin, Chopper, and Dominus. The British Wrestling Invasion have arrived.
Is Rob too much of a punk? Put the belt on the line. a little sissy. What, you scared, Rob? The Australian emu coming after you.
Look at it. It's interesting. It's interesting Perkins' role here because he did not pick up the win at Crisis yesterday, of course. I feel like he's now have a managerial role under Rob, it seems.
There are no rules in the British Invasion. It's a brotherhood. There is no leader. There is no rules.
Well, I said a role, not a rule. There is
no rules.
When it comes to British, there is a lot of ruling.
Yes. It is not a monarchy for the BWI, from what I
a brotherhood.
Everyone equal, except for Rob with the belt currently, I assume.
Yeah, does this make Rob, like, the number one member right now? Because he's got a title and nobody else currently does?
Look at them look into each other's eyes.
Yeah, this
Rob rubs too much olive oil on his skin. Look at him. He's looking Italian.
Perkin is just so buff. It's like when Randy Orton walked out at Survivor Series.
I love that the shirt makes him look even more buff.
Yeah, like his shoulders are so wide. Not the Aussie Avatars, but here we go. Let's go, Avatar.
Alrighty, folks, kicking it off strong.
Oh, no. The ginger end. Oh, into an arm bar. Oh, come on, Rob. Oh, man.
What the hell? I wish this move didn't take 5 minutes.
Oh.
All you did was pull his fingers, Rob.
Is that it?
One.
Only a one count. Do you think Rob respects Aussie Avatar?
I don't think the British know how to wrestle.
Oh.
You heard me, Will.
Who's Will?
Will Ospreay?
Oh.
Come on, bruv. When you join the BWI.
Oh, BWI versus United Empire win?
Oh.
Oh.
Look at him just throwing around the Aussie Avatar like a ragdoll.
And now Aussie trying to get back into this.
Looking like Andre's job squad over there.
Oh, he's better than them.
I mean, yeah, but he looks like them right now.
Yeah, it is all Rob right now. Oh, here it is. The ginger end. Is that
into
the end?
A pin. One, two, three.
Yeah.
I'm surprised Rob didn't cheat. It sounded so, like, mean and dirty the way he said it. Yeah, you little cheater.
He does cheat quite a lot.
I'm sure he didn't beat him. I'm sure he, like, put a thumbtack in his nipple. Just poked him with it. Ah!
Oh!
And then pinned him.
I'll tell him, Pickens. So, breaking news. Rob will be defending that M2J2 title against Mooch next week inside of a steel cage so the BWI cannot get involved.
Wow, that is going to be fantastic, folks.
Wow.
I can't wait for Rob to lose it next week. And now, our big return from Crisis. I wish I put more time into this because Slime Theory is going to be facing Andrew Owen, who returned at Crisis.
In case you missed it, during McHale and I's match, Slime Theory tried to interfere. And I had a feeling this was going to happen again, so I had some backup. A very close friend of mine, Andrew Owen, made his shocking return to wrestling inside of a ShockWrestling ring and jumped off of a ladder in one of the craziest moves we've seen in ShockWrestling, putting Slime Theory through a table, and Slime Theory wanted his revenge and asked you, JVH, for a tables match tonight against Owen.
Yes, and it's going to be great, as you see, in the corner. I don't know if it's still playing. I don't know how long Andrew Owen was there. It felt like forever. I was all alone in the booth, Ace. You were on the side of the stage with McHale. It was chaos. Yeah, Slime Theory was trying to get that box. It was great. That was my favorite part. Slime Theory running down, trying to get the box. Ah! And then Andrew Owen out of nowhere, but he has returned here to ShockWrestling. It's a shame he's going to get fired when you go into the new year, huh?
I doubt that, because this is a great competitor here. Get your popcorn ready, folks. This is one of the most exciting talents we now have on the Monday Night Call roster. Andrew Owen is here.
CAW, more like core combat.
The key was on both.
My jokes still work.
The spider trooper himself making his way down. Very excited to see him get back into an actual physical match now.
Slime Theory, core combat, right?
Yes.
Have these two faced off in the past, Ace?
Probably.
Oh. Rob? I feel like we haven't had to ask Rob a question in a hot minute or two about, you know, Legends eras. Good. All right. Well, my vote is for Spider Trooper tonight, folks. Let's go, Andrew Owen. Take down Slime Theory. Whoa!
Nice hit to the back here.
Confusing me there. We got a lot of big guys versus little guys tonight. Paz and Hieu, Slime Theory, Andrew Owen, Big H, Brett.
Ooh.
Vince McMahon would have never allowed this.
And now, yeah, Andrew Owen, a high flyer. You're going to see some crazy moves here, folks. Look at that.
There you go. Andrew Owen. Whoa! Escaping from Slime Theory there to get a big hit onto him. That's the way to do it. Rumor has it that Omos has been looking for a gig.
Oh.
Speaking of big guys.
Free agent Omos.
I don't know how much that WWE free agency extends to, but here we go. Andrew Owen.
We're going to see
throwing Slime Theory up against the ropes.
It is a tables match. You need to put your opponent through the table to win.
Can he do it? Hit him.
He's getting close.
Hit him, Owen.
He could fall through that table. Oh, man.
Hit him again.
Is it going to work? It didn't break.
They shut the table.
It did not break.
Slime Theory landed incorrectly. Andrew Owens annoyed the table did not break. What's he going to do here, folks?
That's what I'm saying. This is going to be one of the most exciting competitors we'll have here on CAW.
That move needs a name. The spider whip.
Come on, you just played the game. Give us a name.
I'm trying. Look at Slime Theory pinning him up against the wall.
Ooh. Think he could
he
climb
can't even
walls?
Move. Andrew Owen?
Yeah.
That'd be cool. We need to put him in a cell.
Yeah. As Andrew Owen.
Throwing away Slime Theory. What's he going? He's keeping him on the outside of the ring.
Yeah, this is. Now, what's
Slime
he
Theory hasn't
here?
Been able to resist the barricade. Instead of going after the table
one
that
a new
is
table.
Not trustworthy,
yeah,
he's going to grab a brand new one.
Good idea.
Look at him. He was showing the table off. He's like, Slime, you're going to go through this, buddy.
Oh, God.
Nope. Slime's got to be careful there. Yeah. That table is way easily breakable.
I was about to say, he could go through it. It's at an angle where it could happen. No, it's not.
Slime Theory stuck in the corner by Andrew Owen.
Look at this. Oh! There we go.
Wall crawler. I'm trying this.
And now,
I'm really off my game with the names here tonight.
Now throwing Slime into the barricade once again. Slime
embarrassed.
Slime really hasn't had any offense in here. He's supposed to be the powerhouse of the click.
Yeah, but the click sucks.
Slime Theory is the current tag team champions. I don't know why he didn't walk out of his belt. McHale probably has it.
Yeah, he's probably like, this is my team's belt.
It's like when Luchasaurus
won the... It's a world championship.
It's like when Luchasaurus won the TNT title and Christian was holding it for him.
Yeah, exactly. Or even Rosemary walking around with the belt of Artemis that she couldn't even win.
Oh, what a kick.
Super kick there. Hit him with it. Yeah! There we go, Andrew Owen.
There
Put
we
him
go.
Down. Setting up the table. for Slime Theory.
Is this
it? Come on. Come on.
Is this enough? How are we going to... Oh, my God. Oh!
Flipping it through the table. Andrew Owen wins.
What did I tell you? We were going to see something crazy.
This
Look at that again.
Awesome.
Oh.
That was... Only one replay tonight, folks.
That was insane. Congrats to Spider Trooper, his first match here in Shock Wrestling.
Wow, I can't believe we had Spider Trooper show up and the crowd pleaser Nicholas show up on a Monday Night Call. And, wow, things are looking up for me.
All right. I bet a lot of you think you know what I'm about to say now that I'm out here.
Yeah.
But I want to make one thing clear before I get into what I'm really here to talk about tonight. That the events that happened at Crisis do not matter. Because the new clique runs Shock Wrestling. And I don't care if I have to follow or break the rules to make what I want to happen, happen. Which is why next week I will be facing my greatest opponent yet.
Wait, that's the blockbuster title match contract.
McHale versus Superman next week? Well,
thank God he doesn't have the control of CAW anymore.
Let's try to ignore that, because we got to find out who Adam's tag partner is for this match. So, in case you missed it, guys, we had the Legends versus the Originals last night. The Originals won. Adam was the last competitor standing. So that means he is the number one contender for Old Ben's world title. And the contracts have been signed. It will happen on the special holiday special of Monday Night Call, Christmas Day, Old Ben versus Adam for the World Championship.
I have to be with you on Christmas?
Merry Christmas. But here we go. We got a Super Goats matchup tonight, so we're 3 weeks away from that. Very exciting time here. Tis the season, JVH.
Yes, it is. And folks, this is our world champion. It's going to be great. It's going to be huge. Smart world champion shows up, doesn't defend the title all the time. I'm glad he created this tag team with Nova so that he doesn't have to lose the title to some lame guy like, I don't know.
McHale.
We have a lot of lame guys. but... We do have a lot of stuff going on throughout this month, Ace. You know what's going on the Scary Box? The Nutcracker series is releasing throughout this month.
The what?
The what? The Nutcrackers, which is why we have a lot of Nutcrackers in the ring. I don't know if you could see them. Oh, it was a joke. I'm not doing that. You think I'm editing this? Are you crazy? So, we got that, and Ace, you did teach me something as Nova is coming out.
The Triple
I'd like
F
to
champ.
Explain that. Oh, yes, the Triple F champ. This is more important. The Triple F champion,
Who will face the Raven for that belt next week. We got a jam-packed con next week as well.
Yes, it's going to be a fun matchup. But Ace, before Adam comes out with this mysterious partner, you know, you taught me some stuff. You were like, oh, well, you know, sometimes in wrestling, the call after, or the day after the pay-per-view, you have a big return. And there's one person I know that really, really likes Adam. And
oh,
I swear
man.
To God,
oh,
if he
man.
Shows up, I'm leaving.
Oh, man. It could be. It could be. You never know.
And I swear to God, Ace, I don't know what you're doing.
I didn't book this
main
event.
Don't piss me off. Don't piss me off.
You let Adam pick whoever he wanted.
And yeah, if Adam made the wrong decision, I'm going to lose my mind. Because I said he would never return. And
you're a big fan of Adam,
You shall not be named is here in the building. Like Randall Orton. I'm going to lose my mind. On this day.
You're a big fan of Adam, though.
Is Adam gonna change his theme song?
Oh, I'm gonna ask him.
I know. What do you think if I asked Adam what I should make his new theme song? What do you think he'd say? Oh my god, the pyro, I love it.
Him and Andre tonight with the pyro.
I think Andre thinks he's Adam. Andre's wearing the blue like Adam. I am the main event!
Yeah, Adam calls himself the main event no matter where on the card, but he is actually in the main event.
I was about to say, tonight he was right! Good for him!
Here we go. Yeah, Adam's been trying to regain that world title all year, but there's been beacons in his way, injuries in his way. You were in his way at Fight
Night.
Oh,
thank God. Oh. Thank you, God. It's what? Not who I thought, folks.
The hammer?
Ah, oh, the hammer is here.
What could this mean?
And I am
mean?
So relieved.
This is... Let's talk about this for a second, though. This... Why... I don't think the hammer and Adam have ever crossed paths. Why now?
I mean, they've crossed paths, you know, at catering. That's where everybody of our wrestling organization meets. But the hammer is the holder of the scary box and is able to cash it in for any belt here at Shock Wrestling. Could he be going after old Ben tonight? Is that why he's teaming up with Adam? And Adam's a nice guy, so we already know that side of it.
Or is the hammer trying to get close with Adam so when he eventually does turn on Adam, because it's the hammer, he'll cash in and he's going to get to know Adam, find his weaknesses, and then he'll be able to strike, cash in, and become a two-time world champion.
It's weird you say all that because I don't know if Adam's going to be able to get a belt before the end of this year.
I mean, Adam has beaten Old Ben before. Old Ben has never been able to pin Adam.
But we will see, Ace. It's different times here. We have a new manager stepping in.
That's
I don't know
me.
Who, but he's a dork.
Probably. As
probably. Wow.
Here we go. Old Ben and Adam starting things out. Little preview of Christmas.
At least Hammer knew to have Adam start. Look at Nova already jabbing Adam in the side.
Nova trying to help his friend. Oh.
Whoa. Adam looking like Spider-Man over there. Crawling around the ring. Beating up old Ben.
And now grabbing old Ben. Might want some. Are we going to see some double team from these two? What's
going
on here? I like
three of the people in this match.
What is happening here?
Oh. Whoa.
This is just a weird alliance.
Listen, Adam's a nice guy.
That's what I mean.
He sees potential in everybody.
The hammer is the opposite of Adam.
No, the hammer was a former world champion and left the bloodline because they sucked.
The same reason
why Killa left the bloodline.
He demolished his brother at Eruption.
Who cares? Sometimes, in Adam's words, dudes just need to fight. Oh, look, Adam's going back after old Ben. See, why is Adam always bullying old Ben? Uh-oh. Old Ben dropped out of the ring. And Nova goes after Adam. Uh-oh.
I mean, it's really not about fighting or bullying old Ben. It's about becoming world champion again, the belt that he believes is his. Ooh.
The hammer has that same mindset, though. You know.
That's what I mean. How can you trust the hammer? The hammer's trying to get close to the two contenders.
Maybe Adam learned something from the British invasion and wants to create a brotherhood.
Now, Nova defeated the hammer last night at Crisis, so there's some bad blood there.
Nova just wiped out the whole ring. And, with a super Nova.
And here comes the glorious one. Adam back in the ring. Oh.
Was this entrance shorter? I guess we talked a lot. Old Ben's pinned! Oh no! Two!
Oh, he got it! What?
This is... Hammer did nothing!
Does Adam just have Old Ben's number? What happened there?
This is not good, folks.
Man, if that happens at Christmas, that's it for Old Ben.
I can't believe that. What a wild head. I don't think Noah
could believe it. Yeah, Adam and the Hammer, as of this week at least, they're on the same page.
Everybody was distracted by the choice of the Hammer, I guess. I'm shocked.
Yeah, that was actually one of the most abrupt and shocking endings we've had on CAW. Wow. Well, thank you guys for joining us.
Nobody's coming out, thank God. I had to make sure.
No cult of personality playing.
No, he who shall not be named. No, McHale. Next week, folks, we have another great episode of Monday Night CAW. It's going to be huge. We have a ton of matches, and I'm real excited, Ace. We're just on the final countdown towards the end of this year.
Yes, and be sure to subscribe and follow the Instagram. We'll be releasing the nominees for the Shockey Awards this upcoming week. Yeah, because it'll be December. Yes, they will be up. I promise. I won't forget.
Yep. I gotta get Photoshop, folks.
Goodbye!